let's do this. So why is starting a journey so hard to do? Never mind sticking to it. So a couple things that I've been learning in my own research and in studying total wellness, the science of total well-being at Yale, is that our reference points are skewed. Okay, so what we're looking at, who we're talking to, really embed in us either defeat or possibility. So when you're talking about how do I start, you really want to think about who is succeeding and talking to that person. Our brains don't work in absolutes. We don't just out of curiosity ask someone. We sort of really look at who is around us and who and what we're surrounding ourselves with first. So when I began my journey, I remember I cleaned out my Facebook and cleaned out my Instagram and started following people that lived the life that I wanted. The second reason that it's so hard is that our attempts of trying to get healthy or starting on a plan or getting back on track have not had any real feedback. We are so hard on ourselves that we attempt, our attempts perhaps have been because we are so uber critical about ourselves and our own progress. So if we start a program or start to want to do something that's anywhere near starting to move more or feeling healthier or trying to do something different, if we don't do it right the first time, we automatically believe that we can't do it. So that's another pesky part of our brain that doesn't allow us to grow. Our brain really is formed to protect us and not really help us find possibility or find our most healthy, active selves. So you keep that in mind that it is hard. It's supposed to be hard, okay? It doesn't get any easier, okay? Remember that when we all are born, we're born with nothing. I have a 7-month-old myself, and it's insane. He knows nothing. So give yourself a break, be kind to yourself, and keep listening. The third reason that it's so hard is that we don't have a social connection that makes it meaningful. So especially right now, in a time where we are inundated with uncertainty, and we think, oh, I really want to start to like get healthy again, or I want to jump in this and really feel better about it. How are we going to do that? We're supposed to be social distancing. So again, this is why I'm here. This is why I'm reaching out, because that's part of the magic. Making sure you have that social, meaningful connection that will help you stay on track. So today we're going to be making a target program for you. And these are some of the materials that I used. I used a bright colored paper, I used a sticky note, and I used a glue stick to tape on the 5 realms of the holistic approach to total wellness, also connected to our immune health. So you'll need circles. You're going to need to make your targets. These are the targets we're going to be working on. We have balanced nutrition, exercise, mindfulness and relaxation, sleep, and socialization. Okay, and if we hit these targets, you guys, it's going to be unbelievable. So get your artsy self together. If you have sticky notes, awesome, no problem. But you really want to make sure you're writing these things out, because that way you will get something even more out of it. You're going to feel a sense of accomplishment, which is so awesome. And you really want to start thinking about what your targets are, okay? What is it that you want more of underneath these realms? And we'll talk a little bit more about that next. All right, so the target system. It's a visible and proven to give you meaningful feedback. This is what I have been using for the past 5 years. You don't need to go out and reinvent the wheel, you guys. Science has already defined what total well-being is, and the 5 realms are what total well-being is. You're connected to a wellness coach. This is myself, okay, who is in it to win it. I get up in the morning and I sleep thinking, how can I help you? Okay, I have my own success story, which I will share a little later. And that's what makes it so incredible. You have a person who is going the distance with you. And because I'm promoting healthy, active lifestyle, and because it works, our science is globally accepted and aligned with what the Center for Harvard Health has set out as a universal guide. So everything that we're going to be learning is backed by science, whether it's Herbalife Nutrition or whether it's the Harvard Center for Health and Well-Being. It's so close aligned that you are going to find yourself like, oh my gosh, this is amazing. I found what works. What are the targets? So again, you want to start with balanced nutrition. And what I love about this is that with balanced nutrition on your side, you're not basing your success on how well you were able to eliminate food groups or foods. Our approach is based on your goals, and we work together on your goals. Number two is exercise. The goal is one time a day, seven times a week. Remember that it doesn't mean I'm not telling you you got to run a marathon. You've got to run 3 miles every day. You've got to lift so much amount of weight. That comes later. So it's just the first step. Is it walking a mile every day? Is it walking around the block every day? Is it doing your 100 push-ups every day, sit-ups 100 every day? What is it for you? That's where that goal comes in. The third goal is mindfulness and relaxation. And here I really, really believe that a lot of us tend to jump off the boat, because we think, I'm not a hippie. I don't understand why we have to connect our mind to our vision. I don't understand why I have to take time to breathe in deeply. Well, you guys, it's because we exhale our worries. We exhale our excess weight. We exhale our problems. And breath is the sole reason we are alive. So we've got to start to include this component in our holistic approach to well-being. I started with a gratitude journal, saved my life, my attitude. It's amazing when I start the day writing down the three things I'm grateful for. I end the day writing the five things I'm grateful for that I accomplished. It's an incredible feeling, and it's not like buying something that gives you some sort of gratification. They say that people who are grateful and who write down why they're grateful, are their feeling of gratefulness outlasts that buying something and having that thrill up to a month longer. Being, you know, keeping that gratitude journal approach can keep you happier a month longer, okay, by just writing things down. So get your journals, get your favorite pens, and really start to include this part. Meditation allows us to step back from our problems, step back from the world we live in, and be with ourselves in our realm. Much to be discussed about that, but set your goal. What does that mean to you? What do you want more of in that realm? This is what it looks like. And again, the three circles are super important, because the center circle is where you get to gauge yourself for the first 7 days, followed by the next 7 days, which brings you up to day 14, followed by the following 7 days, which brings you to day 28. We are creatures of habit, and so this is why we gauge. We get to see how we did last week and then where we're going, and set new goals every week of each month. Sleep. A lot of us have decided for ourselves that we don't really need a lot of sleep to function. A lot of us think that we need a lot of sleep to function, and science has now stated that people who sleep 9 hours a night are much healthier and happier, okay? Our minds and bodies heal when we sleep. We also repair our muscles when we sleep. And there is no doubt in my mind. The people that I come across and say, I'm so stressed out, and I ask them, how are you sleeping? They either say, I don't sleep, I can't sleep, I don't like sleeping. So, you guys, it's definitely something you want to set a goal up for yourselves right now. Socialization is the fifth and last realm. And you guys, I've had the opportunity to move so many times. I've moved probably about, I don't know, maybe 10, 15 times in my life. I am an immigrant. I came from Colombia in 1986 and have just such an experience with this idea that friends are all over you. I make friends wherever I go. And even if it's, you know, in isolation or not in isolation, it really comes in to play this whole socialization thing with how you feel to begin with. So if you are someone who needs a lot of attention, or maybe you have just this like emptiness inside, I mean, we can go into this forever, but I think the biggest component here is it's better to have a few really good friends than to be surrounded with many friends that rob you of your happiness. So set your goal. What do you want more of in the social realm? The other component is making your social gatherings meaningful. So take a look at that. You know, ask yourself, what do you want to get out of this social gathering? And that's about that. The other component is a lot of science is now backing up the idea that people that embrace their solitude, okay, have those moments of being alone and really face those moments and not like deny them or kind of try to make up for it in unhealthy ways, they are less depressed, less, you know, unhappy. They are less discontent, et cetera, et cetera. So here are some ways that you can really embrace attitude that's healthy. You know, writing a thank you letter, asking people how they're doing, avoid energy suckers, and think about what is good that's happening in your life now. In closing, build your own target system today. Don't hold yourself back, okay? Reach in that memory bank of yours and write down where you came from, okay? And write down, you know, what do you think people would say about you, that you do really well at. You know, that's how you start all of this, is by really looking at what is good, okay? How do you represent what's good? And then reach out, because your personalized nutrition plan awaits. Here's an example of my milestones. In September 2015, I was exhausted and exhausted of being exhausted. I was teaching at a public school, 155 kids every single day, felt like crap, and I would drink myself to death at night and do it all over again 7 days a week. It was super unhealthy. I needed something to change. Back in January 2016, I got my nutrition plan started. I worked on my target system, and I lost 20 pounds with exercise and good food. And in January 2020, I was blessed and got pregnant with my first baby, and I was able to continue my nutrition plan and work on my target system. And in May 2020, this month, you guys, I am down 28 amazing pounds, and I am in the best shape of my life. It's time. We hope you'll use these tips to go out and live your best life.